Good morning, and thank you for tuning in to the Live in 5 show, where we are living live.
Veteran base jumper Vince Riffey and Fred Fugan break a world record.
Playoffs still continue for the Hockey League and the NBA.
And will the cool weather last in this April weather? Let's find out more in the weather report.
Tony Parker, the 14-year NBA veteran, is determined to bring his team to a championship for a second time in a row.
Will Ferrell joined Oprah on an interview and he started crying. Oh, what the heck. Stay tuned for more details.
That and so much more coming up shortly.
Don't have a yearbook or do you want to buy one to your friend? Well, we have a solution for you. So talk with First School and raise money to purchase a yearbook. It's easy. Just go to the link on my left and print the permission slip. Then turn it into Mr. Porter in room 205 and he'll give you more information.
So, welcome back.
Now it's time for the Pit Test-Off play-by-play.
Payments for any pictures you have kept need to be returned into the bureau in the student office today. If you are not keeping any pictures, please return them to the bureau in the student office.
Tomorrow, more than 75 Tetzoff children will be competing in the STEM Science Olympics. They will teach their knowledge, they will test their knowledge and skill against all middle schools in the district. We wish the best of luck and have fun on Saturday to bring home the gold.
Trendsday Wednesday is Trendsday Friday. Catching up from 2 days ago, we now have to go to the trendy G-Shawn Josie with our trend for this week.
Welcome to Trendsday Wednesday. I'm G-Shawn. This week's trend is 5 Gum.
New 5 RPM gum. Choose your energy. Energizing fruit or relaxing mint flavor. New 5 RPM gum. Stimulate your senses.
The name 5 hints the 5 human senses. The brand features 17 flavors of chewing gum, which are available in the U.S. with the exception of Cyrus, Zephyr, and Evolution. That's it for the trend of the week. See you next time with another great trend.
The Crazy Vines are back with Matthew Scammerhorn. Let's roll back to yesterday and get a laugh out of this segment.
Hey Trojan, Matthew here again with some more funny vines. Today's compilation comes from a viner named Ray Lagaya. These vines are really funny. Enjoy these vines.
Public singing.
You are my fire.
Man, there's no parking anywhere.
Right. We're here.
Those vines were hilarious. And also, did you know that a branded vine is more likely to be seen than a branded video? All right, those are the vines for today. I'll be back next week with more Thursday Vines.
Today's segment is Useless Talents, hosted by Asher. Let's see if this talent is as useless as cutting a BB gun bullet.
This is Asher with Friday's Useless Talent. Today we witness a man capable of solving complex math problems in his head.
We'll start with the multiplication of two-digit numbers. Ready? The numbers are 39 times 78.
302
is correct. Scott got it first.
Scott's speed is baffling everyone in the room. As the challenges get harder, Scott is actually getting faster.
Okay, starting with a base of 0 and adding 10 times. The number is 48.
96, 144, 192, 240, 288, 313, 384, 432, 480.
Yes. Wasn't that cool? Did you know if you divide a long side of a normal piece of paper by the
Oh, that's it for the play-by-play test off. We'll be right back after the break. Eyes, zone down. On April 29th, the Vasquez Police Department in Minnesota received a tip about a suspicious activity in a storage facility. When doing a search of the storage facility, police found a journal that contained plans to shoot students at the suspect's school. The police claimed that the gunman was inspired by other shootings like the Sandy Hook Elementary shooting. The suspect is a 17-year-old high school student named John David Laud. Authorities also say that the teen's plan was very well planned out and would have been successful if they hadn't stopped him. His neighbors were shocked when they heard about this. They say that John was a very kind and quiet person. The police are just glad that they stopped the teen in time.
A couple of weeks ago, veteran base jumpers Vince Riffet and Fred Fugan break a world record by jumping off the world's tallest building, the Burj Khalifa, building in Dubai stands at an astonishing 2,717 feet. The two brave men trained a long time for this base jump. Let's see what's going on in the world of entertainment. Good morning, Alyssa. How are you today?
Thank you, Isabel. On the show Opera Prime with Farrell, Will Ferrell joined Oprah on interview. He started crying, not due to sad, because of being happy. Oprah showed Will a video of people around the world singing and lip-syncing to the song Happy. Ferrell starts to show his emotional side at the sight of his fans supporting his profession. He believes he doesn't deserve something so amazing as a large group of people believing in his success. Ferrell's song Happy has a contagious effect on people around the world and Ferrell himself. Let's see what's going on in the world of weather. Good morning, Jorge.
Good morning, Alyssa. Now, I had earlier said about the April showers and the April weather. Well, since we're going into May, we might not have that cool weather, but the weather right now is being a little contradicted, so let's get to your forecast and see what it says. We have 68 in Los Angeles. So far, so cool weather, but let's hope it stays like that. We have 91 in Phoenix, 87 Las Vegas, 77 Albuquerque, 83 Oklahoma, 74 Kansas City. We have 81 in Memphis and 76 in St. Louis.
And for the rest of the nation, sorry, my TV monitor is not working, so I'm going to have to disappear for a moment. And we also have 91 in Norfolk and 62 in New York.
Time now for your five-day forecast.
Today will be 74 degrees, tomorrow 75 degrees. Sunday coming up to an 82 degrees, Monday 91, and Tuesday to a scorching 96 degrees. All those days mostly sunny. Your weather fun fact for today is, the South Pole and the Antarctic has no sun for 182 days a year. And if you don't know how many days a year, there's around 365 days a year.
Wow, that's a lot of darkness. All right, let's get to your web poll.
Good morning, Dylan.
All right, thank you, Jorge. Now today I have Vince with us. Good morning. Now this week or last week, we asked you if Tesla should get a swimming pool. Here's what you said.
Yeah, I guess.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, Tesla should have a swimming pool.
Yes.
No.
You know, that would be really nice.
Yes, it should. Because it'll make kids more active, and being active is really important.
So all the students could go swimming.
Because it's fun to swim in the water.
Results for this past week's poll. 73% of you said yes, they wanted a pool. 13% of you said no, and 14% of you said they didn't care. Our new question is, should Tesla get a school mascot? We want to hear from you. Be sure to visit us online at Long5ShowToVote. Send your comments to webpoll@long5show.com, and if it's good, we'll read on air. So, Aaron, do you think we should get a school mascot for Tesla?
Well, yes, because it'll be showing more school pride.
Cool. All right, thank you. Now, here's Johnny the Sports.
In basketball, Brooklyn Nets beat Toronto Raptors 114-113, and I'm sorry because this is the Monday script from when we didn't have a show. And win the series to take on the Heat, and San Antonio beats Dallas 119-96, and wins the series to take on the Trailblazers. OKC beats Memphis 120-104, and wins the series to take on the Clippers. The Clippers beat the Warriors 126-121 and win the series to take on the Pacers. Pacers beat Hawks 92-85 and win the series to take on the Wizards. And Trailblazers beat Rockets 99-98 after a game-winning three by Damian Lillard and 8.8 seconds left in the clock to win the series and take the Spurs. In baseball, Red Sox beat Athletics 6-3, Dodgers beat Mariners 9-7, Giants beat Braves 3-1, Angels beat Rangers 5-3, and Diamondbacks beat Padres 4-3. In hockey, Penguins beat Rangers 3-0, and series tied 1-1, and Blackhawks beat Wild 4-1, Blackhawks lead series 2-0. In soccer, Real Madrid beats Valencia 2-2, Chelsea ties Norwich City 0-0, and Arsenio beats West Bromwich 1-0. Yesterday in basketball, Clippers beat OKC 122-105. Clippers beat lead series 1-0, and then Thunder beat Clippers 120-105 again. I'm sorry, and tie the series. In baseball, Nationals beat Dodgers 4-0, Giants beat Pirates 11-10, Angels beat Yankees 4-1, Mariners beat Athletics 4-2. In hockey, Penguins beat Rangers 2-0, Penguins win the series 2-1, and Kings beat Ducks 3-1, Kings lead the series. In soccer, Crystal Palace ties with Liverpool 3-3. Tony Parker, the 14-year-old NBA veteran, is determined to bring his team to the championship for a second time in a row. The San Antonio Spurs are trying to win the quarterfinals series against the Dallas Mavericks. Parker currently is averaging 16.7 points per game, 6 assists, and 2 rebounds a game. Parker is destined for another championship title, and with his talent and competitiveness, he might get his ring. Many good point guards in the past years, but some of them have stood out in the NBA 2014 season. In the number 3 spot is none other than John Wall with the Washington Wizards with 471 two-point makes. In second place is Stephen Curry, who plays for the Golden State Warriors, which is no surprise considering the league's premier three-point shooter. Last but not least is Chris Paul with the Los Angeles Clippers and is often referred to as the first point guard. Kevin Durant, small forward of the Oklahoma City Thunder, has won his first Most Valuable Player Award in the NBA for the second time in a row, for the first time actually. Kevin averages 32 points per game, 7 rebounds, and 5 assists. Durant, MVP for the first time, shows his skills and determination. Kevin's planning on making it to the Hall of Fame, and with his way of playing, the Hall of Fame is not that far from him. That's it on sports. Time now for the Daily 401 Challenge with Isabel.
Thank you, Johnny. Okay. What is the phobia of gravity? Algophobia, anthrophobia, barophobia, or graphobia? Take 5. Barophobia is the fear of gravity. Ooh.
Last month, Stephen Richardson asked his beloved girlfriend one of the most important questions ever asked in life. Will you marry me? He and Brandi Roonen were on a hot air balloon ride for a half an hour and they were near the city when he asked her to marry him. She said yes, and right after the balloon flew into a power line, the balloon went up, but the basket they were in went down and there was even an explosion. They called the fire department and luckily they were fine. It's a day this couple will never forget. That wraps up the show for today. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at Line 5 Show, and we'll catch you back here on Monday. Don't wake me up, don't wake me. So much life in the-